I've always been a dreamer, you know, being the greatest drummer in the world, stuff like that. I would say I did it all. I've been in disco bands, jazz bands, rock and roll bands. I was coming down Edgewater Road and a lady pulled out in front of me and it went through her passenger window and out the front window and then rolled on the concrete. So it was pretty traumatizing, I know that. You know, I never had an injury like that. So when I got out, I thought everything, I was feeling okay, you know. And then progressively as the years went on, it started getting worse and worse. They gave me some hellacious drugs when I was going to my doctor. Things that just put me out of my mind, out of my world, you know, as far as taking the pain away. I kind of downfell from there, and next thing you know, I ended up on the street. I was fortunate enough to sleep in a shed.
For a little while, it looked pretty hopeless because he didn't have a place to stay and he had these medical conditions. He did a couple times call me and just say, I can't do this anymore. I have to go into the hospital and you'll probably see another readmission. And I said, you know, whatever you need to do, Michael, to keep yourself safe, that's the most important thing. And if you feel like you have to go to the hospital, then do that.
Going around to mental hospitals just to have a place to sleep at night was horrible. All you have to do is say you're gonna harm yourself and you can get in. I did that for a year or so.
Rising Star started a number of years ago. We were having people who were repeatedly hospitalized so that there was no treatment continuity, no way for them to get better because they were always starting over.
My job is to help them help themselves and to help them solve the complex problems that they're dealing with in their life. In Michael's case, Michael needed housing.
So the first thing we started doing was looking at shelters, and I had a list of about 100 to go through.
It's people who are involved in this program really believe in the mission that we all are on, and that is to help improve people's lives.
Michael didn't have a phone, but we arranged to meet him at a local place that was close named Sunway.
We went through like a 3-hour meeting inside, but we got it done.
We was able to get in that apartment and it all happened so quickly, but he had no furniture. I borrowed a friend's van and went to various thrift stores.
I look in the van, it's packed. I mean, just totally packed and stuff that we can't lift.
One of the basic premises of integrated care is that it really does address the whole person's needs. And what we found is that over the long run, it lowers cost and it dramatically improves the outcome because it balances everything out.
Michael was able to get back on his feet, secure housing, have the medical operations that he needed to hopefully put him in a better place.
You know, I'm just really proud of him. A year from now, I might be going to listen to Michael play.
I use this in every gig I've ever done. I've probably used it in 5 different bands, and it's nowhere near about to break. Yeah, I dream about drumming. It's heaven to me. That's for sure. It's definitely heaven.